Hi, my name is Adam Riskin, and I'm the BlackLine practice leader here at Revelwood. And today we're going to do a demo of how to do a bank reconciliation within BlackLine. So this is how most companies do bank reconciliations today. They'll take the bank statement data and dump it out to an Excel file, take the general ledger journal entries, dump them out to an Excel file, and then put them side by side and match them one by one. So for example, I have this $25,000 deposit on my bank statement, and I have these three journal entries over here that sum up for the same amount. And so go ahead and mark them as complete, either color code them and mark them off. And now, You'll use different logic to complete this. It could be a one-to-many match, is what we're using here right now. Could be a many-to-many match, or it could be a one-to-one match. And after going through that exercise, what gets completed is something that looks like this. You'll have one bucket of records, which is all your match records. You'll have another bucket of records, which is your unreconciled records. And then you'll have your final cash account reconciliation, or other people call it the bank-to-book report. So what BlackLine does is it automates this entire process. So let's take a look at exactly how it does it. So here are those same records that are loaded into BlackLine. On the left is the bank statement transactions, and on the right is the general ledger transactions. Should look almost identical to the Excel file that I showed you before. Now, the way BlackLine is able to match these records is by using what it calls the pass rules. And so that's all the logic that you use today in your head to match records in Excel. All that logic gets recreated in the system as pass rules. And so in this example, we have three pass rules created. The first one here is a many-to-many match, where it will look at multiple bank transactions and see if they match up to multiple journal entries from your general ledger. The second pass rule is a one-to-many match, where it will look at one bank transaction and see if it matches up to multiple journal entries. And the last pass rule is the simplest, a one-to-one match, where it will look for one bank transaction and see if it matches up to one single journal entry from your general ledger. So let's now see how BlackLine actually matches these records. I'm actually going to go ahead and run those two data sets through BlackLine's matching engine. So the system has finished matching the records. Let's first take a look at the records that the system was able to successfully match. So what we're looking at here is a full audit trail of what records the system matched. You can see here that this first set of records is a many-to-many match. These first three records right here, these are from my bank statement, and they sum up to $2,000. Where on my journal entry side, these two records over here sum up to $2,000 as well. So the system was able to mark it as a match. In the second example, I have one bank transaction for $25,000. On my right side, I have three journal entry transactions that also sum up to $25,000. So the system was able to mark it as a match. Now, this isn't a screen that you typically will need to go into on a regular basis, but it's there if you need it, or in case auditors want to see how your system is doing the matching, they can come in here and see the full audit trail. Now let's take a look at the records that the system wasn't able to successfully match. So all that's remaining is these four records right here. I have three on my bank statement and one on my general ledger. Now in this example, you can see that we have one record on our bank statement for $6,500. And on our right, we have one record on our journal entry. We have one journal entry that was recorded for $6,005. So in this case, the journal entry was probably recorded for the wrong amount. So we need to create an additional journal entry to correct that. And then these two records down here, bank fees and Amex fees, they just need to get booked to the general ledger as well. So to complete this rec, now let's mark these records as reconciling items, and it will get pushed to the final bank to book report. The first one I'll do is for the journal entry that was posted for the wrong amount. What I'm doing here is marking it as a reconciling item. I'm giving it a subtype of journal entry adjustment. That's letting me know that I need to book that to the GL. And those two records are marked. Bank fees, we want to do something similar. We want to mark it as a reconciling item that needs to get posted to the ledger. We'll set the subtype to bank fees. And now that's marked as a reconciling item. The last item is Amex fees. So we're going to book that as a credit card fee to enter into our ledger. Okay, so all these transactions are marked as reconciling items. Now let's go take a look at that cash reconciliation, that final bank to book report, to see how these were pushed to it. Okay. So here's my final cash reconciliation, my balance sheet reconciliation. You can see the three items that we marked as reconciling items are here as supporting items. So the last thing to do is take the ending bank balance from my bank statement and enter it here onto the rec. Okay, so now my reconciliation is complete. My bank balance plus my reconciling items of $630 now matches my GL balance to the penny. And not only have I completed this rec, but all the information about the reconciliations here in one spot. I have my GL balance, I have my supporting items, I have my ending bank balance, and I'm able to see the audit trail of all the records that the system was able to successfully match for me. And that concludes the demo. I appreciate everyone taking the time to watch. If you have any questions, please reach out to us at info@revelwood.com. Thanks.